Hi there, it's Tanya from Tutty Treasures. Hello and welcome back and welcome to new subscribers. Welcome aboard. It's nice to have you here. If you want to say hello or anything in the comments, please feel free. So today, oh look at these loveliness. I'm going to do another one in the Edith Holden, making some ephemera. So I've got some of the decorator's paper, some handmade paper, some dictionary paper, some straw paper, bit of piano roll. I'll probably use it on that side. I have got the book pages from the Edith Holden Nature Notes. I'm trying to use some because I've got a big stack of them. So the last, well, I don't know, four, five, six videos, we've been using up these backing papers. Now this idea, I was going to do something similar anyway, but I did get, well, Julie re-reminded me. So Julie's from Camellia Crafts, and she did some lovely little notebooks on the craft card, and I remembered sometimes when I buy craft envelopes, I buy the ones with the greetings cards in them, because they're no extra money really, and then you're actually getting the card and you can use the card for all sorts of things, and even if it's just cutting it up for tags and things like that. But yeah, I'm going to make some booklets. So let me start by getting my bow folder and just I don't know why I needed to turn it around to do it, because I've got it in exactly the same position. Oh, bizarre. How bizarre. So yeah, I'm just gonna do a really bad job of doing that. I don't know why I'm doing it on the book. And obviously I'm going to use some music paper as well. I need to take a page out of it. But I thought I'd just show you the music book that I do use. I've bought this one now 3-4 times, and I got it from Amazon. It's a lovely size, and it's really old. Look at these end sheets and papers. So it's called News Chronicle Music for the Home, and yeah, this is the one I pick up, and it's really lovely paper. It's very like the Edith Holden. It might even be a little bit thicker. So just going to go through. I like it when it's quite dramatic. Music. I wonder if that is dramatic, you know, when they play it. Because yeah, I do like that. I'm just doing a book flip through of the music book. So anyway, this is the book that I use. So we've got lots of different papers to use. So I've not really thought about this. Can you tell? My mum just rang. We don't speak that often. She only lives up the road type thing. Not been seeing each other since COVID. And we are both the kind of people who we'd prefer to ignore each other than speak to each other, because we find that harder. And yeah, we're both very similar. So yeah, I don't talk to her that often, probably every couple of weeks. So when we do talk, like we're on the phone about an hour, which is lovely, because we've not got a lot to talk about, you know. Nobody's been anywhere, nobody's done anything. So yeah, that was nice. So yeah. So I feel a little bit dizzy now. I don't know if it's the excitement or what, because yeah, it was a really good conversation. It was nice and chatty, and it's so nice to speak to somebody else, because yeah, I've not been speaking to anybody apart from, you know, Ryan and Eleanor. Right, so we've got some papers. We've get my chair comfy. Right, I'm going to use some of these. And what am I doing? Oh yeah, so I need things a bit more wider. So this is going to be a good one. So I'm literally, I might cut these, rip these smaller, but for now I'm just going to get four. So I've got one for each notebook, and it's really just to collage it in. But yeah, I just want to look for the right kind of text. That's fine. So I took two Edith Holden books apart yesterday. I've took the Country Diary and the Nature Notes, because I will be starting on some Edith Holden folios soonish. Not soon, but soonish. So I was just gonna keep those for I want to do some more tags, and they're perfect for the background. Yeah, I forgot what I was saying. Yeah, so I've just took another two books apart ready, and I've sorted them out into folders. So I've put a folder with book pages, what I've just got, like little bits of pictures on, which they're going to get fussy cuttered, and the double page spreads, I've kept them together, and the single picture pages, I've kept those together, and then all the text ones. So now I've got even more text, but obviously I do need to stop making Edith Holden ephemera so I can get on with making folios. I'm just gonna take this one out just so there's one extra for just in case. So yeah, once I've done some folios, I'll come back and do some more Edith Holden ephemera, because I really enjoy working with it. Even just working with the text, it's really nice. Right, so we don't need those. They're going to be for some tags that I'm going to make next week. Right, I'll put those in my scraps, what's left. So we're going to start off with the bases. I'm not going to put the pages in on camera. I might pause, sew them and come back. We shall see how we get on for time. So round the edges, I am going to use walnut stain, and I've got my tea dye ink out. To go around the Edith, well, the paler things. And I've got my basket out of Edith Fussy Cuts. Now, if you remember the last time I had the basket out, I did, I think I put a clip on the bigger pictures. So we perhaps might be able to use some of those bigger things on the front. So I'll put those to the front. I suppose I best get my mat out. Oh, I'm sorry if I'm really appearing all kind of scatty. Yeah, I feel really scatty. Not a great time to video, Tanya, but this is what I'm doing. This is what I'd planned out for today. So it's a Sunday here today. I'm filming a good 2 weeks in front. That's not very good crease, is it? And I did crease it on the factory crease. What I might do is trim it down actually with my trimmer, just to get it straight. It feels really thick, this one, as if there was two, but there's not. So I'm just gonna just get those ends straightened. I don't know if it's just this one or or all of them. I think these were Dovecraft ones. They're always really reasonable price. I think it was just that one. That's a little bit off, but I don't think I'd have noticed it like if I hadn't have been on Wonky Watch. Oh, I like that, Wonky Watch. Oh dear me. Yeah, so it's a Sunday and it's late afternoon. It's about 3:30-ish. I need to finish about 5. Because we're having tea and I think we're watching a DVD. We had Christopher Robin at Christmas and I keep saying, can we watch that? Nobody really wants to watch it. But I'm hoping, excuse me, that that they'll let me watch it. So, I know that I'm going to cry. Because when I saw the trailer, every single time I saw the trailer, I burst into tears. Don't know why, but yeah. So, yeah, I'm probably going to be just a mess. That's probably why they don't want to watch it. Because they'll always say, oh, you'll start crying. You best not watch this mum because you'll be crying. I don't know how much you can actually see of this. To me, I can notice the difference. I'll do the insides after. But for now, we'll just get the outsides done. So that's two. I'm going to pause and do the rest. Right, they're all inked. I've calmed down a little bit. Yeah, I think I was just giddy because I was excited because I spoke to my mum. So yeah, I've inked and I've used the brush and just brought it in a bit. I've done the inside. Put that away now because I use the tea dye. So first I'm going to use... I said I calmed down, didn't I? I'm going to pick what images to use on the front. Now, I do like this, but it would mean, I don't know, about cutting it off there. So I could use that and cut it off there, because if I cut it off there, it just looks a bit weird, those flowers being down there. So that's a good possibility. I think these are going to still be too big. They'll either be too long or too big. So yeah, that's just a bit nothing-y. That's too wide. Ooh, I might have to get the book out and yeah, I need some tall ones, but not too tall. This purple one could be a contender, but I feel like it's going to be too tall. So I suppose we could take that bit. Yeah. That's a contender. I've got the beautiful foxglove here, which that's too big. They probably a good size. So I got to cut that off. So I don't know if it's my other scissors. There. That's take this off first because I can probably use both of these images. Now I'm gonna have to take that leaf there and bring it around there. Yep, come on, turn. Oh, that's it. Neaten that up after. No, I don't think that's not going to be right. That's again way too wide. Let's see if I've got anything in here that I've overlooked or are they all too tiny. it's a bit, it goes lovely with the craft paper, but I think as a cover picture, it's not quite in the mustard. Right, I'm gonna have to pause and get the books down. Yeah, I thought I'd just have plenty. I haven't really, now I think about it, I haven't really got a lot in there. So these are the, I've put the file folders kind of together. So these are the ones that I want. So I can show you how I've organised it actually. This is, I've got two folders like this. So this is the one with full images. I mean, obviously I could still cut these out if I wanted. And these are like the fussy cut ones. And these are the double ones. So I've just pinned them like that. So I'm thinking we'll probably go for these, which are out of, ooh, that probably fit on there. I think this is from How To Something Your Garden. It's all the books that I've used are in my Amazon storefront link, and there's a section what says Edith Olden on. So in there, it'll have all the books that I use, because a lot of the times I then can't remember which ones they're from. It might be How To Create a Butterfly Garden or something like that. It could be out of cooking notes. Too big. Let's take that off and put that in my, I might want to use that. So we're looking for images about that big, aren't we? So, you know, I'm gonna take that nettle out and I might use that one, because I think then I'll be able to have the full nettle instead. Yeah, so this is how to make the most of your butterfly garden. So I'm going to pause, I'm going to cut these out, and then we've got those images. Just thought I'd just show you how fast it's snowing. Probably can't really get a sense of it, but yeah, it's really coming down fast. I'm so sorry. It's quite nice sitting at my desk and looking out in the snow, especially because I haven't got to go out in it. So yeah, sorry about that if that made you feel a bit ill. Right, so all those are cut down. We'll start with the nettle one, and I'm just going to use the tea dye around here. And we'll just do a simple collage around the back of it. I'll link all of them while I'm at it. A bit hard to get into because I've gone quite round the leaves and that just to try and get them as thin as possible. I think that one has been inked apart from where I've just cut it off. And this one, to be so careful that you don't rip the leaves as you do it. Right, that will do. Right, so we've got some text. So So let's think whereabouts we want it. So I think that would be nice. Let me just move my coffee cup because it was cold. Right, thinking we'll have a strip. And oh well, part of that, and it just makes it easier then for them to rip from if they're in smaller pieces. And I'll get some of the handmade paper. A bit of straw paper. So I've got a bit of everything. Now I'm going to put some material down the edge, and the lovely Helen sent me, well I think that one I purchased, and then Helen sent me some more. So that's got a bigger pattern on it, so I think I will save that for journal covers. So I'm going to, I've never used this before, I'm gonna cut a strip about, I don't know if you can see, just over an inch, and I'm gonna hopefully rip it down. Just gonna do it slowly. Oh, it pains me to do this, but I've not bought it not to use, and I'm only using an inch all the way down. So that's that. I might need a little bit more, we shall see. A million things on the table. Right, so I was going to put that on there like so, but I'm actually going to attach that after I've sewn, and then that'll just hide the stitching. So I want to bear in mind that that's going to be there. Yeah, I think it'll look fine. Fine with whatever. Right, so let's get some music going down the side. So I'm going to bring this in a little bit like so. I think I'm going to take that all the way to the bottom. So I just said so a million times. I feel like I've just said it loads. Right, that's that. Then we want some green in there. This is a beautiful colour. I can't remember where I actually got it from. Because I would have some more. It was a mixed paper pad, and some of it was really tough to to rip, because obviously it's got the fibres in it. But this piece is really very nice. This is one of the last pieces that I've got. Then let's throw some. I want the bottom edge a bit straighter. Right, I'm not liking that at all. It just looks like a hodgepodge. A hodgepodge of stuff. I like that there, and I like that. Maybe I don't need so much. I don't need to cover the entire pad front. See, I really do like that on there. I think that's the right spot for that. I want that about there. Like, I quite just like that. And then if we've got the material down the side, like so, feel like that needs to be over some more. Might put burlap down this one. But yeah, I kind of just like that. I'm gonna stick this piece down first, because I do want something right down that edge. Oh. Every time I start using this, it's the on-off thing is quite. It doesn't take a lot to go from off to completely at full speed. Let me just get this off while it's still wet. That looks nice there. Don't know where my other dab has gone. You can probably see it. We've not had this much snow for ages. But if it's still snowy tomorrow, I might put it in the blog. Might take Colin out. So I do like that there. And then if we've got a strip of something here, so do I want it more central? No, I like that at the top. So let's. Oh, I like that. Just do that. I've just torn it the total wrong way that I wanted it. Don't know if you can even see that piece. Ah, that's it. So I'm going to go for that there. Let me turn this down a little bit. Yeah, the collage is not flowing today. It's funny, you know, sometimes it just doesn't. And I don't think it's like what mood you're in or anything. It's just sometimes it just does not flow. Find it difficult than other times. It's very bizarre. I've been doing quite a bit of collage. I've not over collage myself out, but yeah, it's not like sometimes when you've not done for a while, you're a bit rusty. So yeah, just not like that. But yeah, I think I'm gonna put some burlap or something up that side. Right, let's see if I can stick this on without getting glue everywhere. Starting to go a little bit dark now. Yeah, but yeah, if it's still snow tomorrow, I think I'll take Colin up the fields for a little trot round in the snow, and I'll video it and put it on the vlog. So yeah, I'm pleased with that now. I have got a thing what says what it is, so I might just cut this down and see what it looks like. Feels a little bit too big. Let's just cut. Right, she just wanted to see if I'd seen the snow. She was like, look how deep it's getting now. So I don't know, I'm watching it out my window. I've just said to her about taking Colin tomorrow. To see what her school schedule's like, because some of her lessons are live ones, so she has to be, you know, at the computer for the right time. So that's that. I'm quite happy with that. It was a bit of a long starting off, but that's fine. I should probably go around these after and just make sure they're all glued down. Right, so let's have a look. Start off with that. And we'll go with a smaller text. So we'll have that there. This one's quite green, isn't it? So I might have some. Now I've probably done it the way that I've just done it there. I might follow that on, especially with this one, because this one's got a lot of green. So I don't know if I like how I've ripped that. It's better that way. Like so. So I said it's Sunday, didn't I, mate? Love to another film. Well, this week Alan has chosen all our dinners. You'll never guess what we're having for tonight. She's made some really good choices. Last night we had meatballs in a tomato sauce on pesto mash. We used to have it quite often at one time, and it's one of those things you do it every single week and then everybody's had enough of it. And I'm sure all the mums know exactly what I mean. You know, when you find a recipe and everybody loves it, nobody moans, everybody eats it, you tend to keep doing it and doing it until they're like, no more. So I'd actually forgot about it. I've been like, why Eleanor's been off this time, because they're in a lot better routine with the school, because they used to be able to do the work at any time, whereas now, I like that. Now she's got to be at the computer from, you know, what she'd be at school time. So it's meaning she's just in a better routine than what she was in last time, because she got into the, you know, staying up late, not getting up early, and it just meant the days was very, I don't like either end of that, the days was very, very short. So yeah, because she's been in more of a routine and we've got more kind of daytime, I've been getting her involved in like meal planning and, you know, making the shopping list and things like that. So oh yeah, I've still not told you, have I? Yeah, I like that. We're having egg and bacon. yeah, we're having egg, bacon, sausages. So for people who don't live in the UK, it's what we call a full English breakfast. So it's eggs, bacon, sausage, hash browns, mushrooms, tinned tomatoes, baked beans. I did think I'd got some black pudding because Ryan likes it, but I haven't, so we're not having that. I think I've mentioned everything, so yeah, we're having that. And I do like that as a tea, because I don't know about you, but I couldn't eat all that in a morning. And obviously, you know, people only ever eat it on holiday and, you know. Sometimes, when we used to go out walking, we'd sometimes have a fry up first thing, because then it'd keep us going, you know, till after dinner. So yeah, that's what we're having for us tea. So, and I don't mind cooking it, but oh, there's so many pots when you've finished. Like, you seem to use every single... I mean, I obviously grilled the sausage and the bacon, and I put the hash browns in the oven. You've got to fry the mushrooms, fry the eggs, a saucepan for the beans, saucepan for the tomatoes. Yeah, two frying pans. And then, like, your grill pan and whatever you know, you're going to cook it in the oven. So, and then obviously all your cooking needs a good wipe down, because it's everything squattered up it. So, yeah, as much as I don't mind doing it, because it's a pretty quick, you know, from putting the oven on and getting the hash browns in, it's like 30 minutes and it's on the table. Oh, and I love tinned tomatoes. I'm making myself hungry now. Dipping my bread in the tomatoes. It's really, really nice. Yeah, I am. I'm hungry. my chops started going... But yeah, we're not having it till, I think we said 6 o'clock. And then by 7 we should I should be watching a film and then I can probably get straight to bed. I've got the dentist in the morning, which I keep expecting to hear from them that they've cancelled it, because I've had two or three cancelled since March. But I've had a crown fall out and three teeth smash at the back of my mouth because the crown fell out, which then left the other teeth really vulnerable, and yeah, they've all smashed. So yeah, my teeth are in a bad way. Guessing I could end up with like dentures at the back, because I'd already had one taken out from the back, so it's going to mean that I'm four teeth missing at the back. But yeah, when the crown fell out, I'd made an appointment to go, and then that's when lockdown started and what have you. Right, that's that one. So yeah, they look quite similar. Let's see if we can jolly these brighter ones up. What are we at? 41. Yeah, it's took longer than I would have wanted. So I like that there. I'm going to ink around that. Yeah, so I think I'll do the covers. And then all I'm going to do is get some paper, cut it down to size, and I'm just going to sew them in. And then the ones, the florally ones, I will put the Edith Alden material, and the other two I will put some burlap, something like that. So I will do that off camera, but I will put a picture in the thumbnail for you to see, because you've seen me put little booklets together. If you are new and you do want to see me do it at another time, then please do let me know. But I know that I have done it a lot. I could probably point you in the right direction if you wanted to find one that I've done already. I think I did a few in the Woodland series. Right, so I'll have that like that. No, I'm not liking that. The music paper just doesn't, I think, you know why? It's because the writing's brown and that's black. That must be why it's not gelling. Right, let's I just thought it's gonna be too pale. That might work, and then a splash of green in it. So a try of that. We'll use some piano paper in the botanical series. I've not used any for a long time. When I first use piano paper, I did quite a lot of things with it, but it's just one of those things again with the dinners, you overdo it, don't you, and then it's like, oh, I've had enough of that. But yeah, I've not really done anything with it for a long time. So I have got some videos. I think it's in making ephemera playlist. So if you are looking for other videos, I have sorted them all out into playlists. Right, so I'm going to place that around there. I'm going to stick that around there. quite an itchy eyebrow. Right, I wonder if that would be better that way. That there. See, that's gonna have that fabric. Like so. I think I'm going to take this down a little bit to there. So if that was halfway on ish, then we had that there. This picture there. Again, I don't think I'm going to use that fabric. I don't know. When Julie did hers, I thought, oh yeah, what a brilliant. It looked really nice. I don't know if her surface was bigger. I'm not sure what size paper she was using. But yeah, I'm just not feeling it at all. So I might make some clusters with that. Yeah, I'm not feeling this. Okay, it needs something else. Yeah, I'm liking that better. So let's get that down. Yeah, it's obviously all a bit too pale. Just looked up then just to look at the snow. I love snow. You know when it's all on the trees and stuff, there's something really magical about it. The sky looks absolutely full. And I do like it when it's going to evening and it's still like really bright because of the snow. Get back using that. Keep going for the art glitter glue. I'm trying to break the habit, but you know I do need it for certain things. Oops. Probably take that down a little bit. Okay. I was just thinking, I wonder if it's quite dark on camera, but it's not. I've got my ring light on, but so that's that. That's that. I prefer that. Hey, ain't that funny? I'm going to put this on. Wow. Maybe it's the image. I mean, I do like the image, but I'm not a pink person. Yeah, I'm really not a pink person. I do like purple. Yeah, pink, it's not a colour I do like. Yeah, I used to like it. I had a pink Laura Ashley bedroom when I was growing up. That was beautiful. Right, yeah, I'm happy with that one. Right, we need to do one for that one again. So that's that. Right, so we've got this left. We're not feeling the music. Now, just that on its own looks fine. Let's just try put those in the scraps. Just wondering about doing just a long strip of this. I like that, but I feel like there's something missing. So I'm going to start by gluing this down. Try and get around these edges. But again, when everything does dry, I do go around and check. The art gliss is brilliant for that, obviously, with a nice tip. So that's there. I'm going to put that there. Can you see as well? I've actually positioned the art glitter right next to me, and the clout, I am really reaching that way. It's put this on and put it out the way. In fact, I'm just putting the lid on and I just need it now. Right, so yeah, I like that. But I'm just gonna, well, how about you? It's gonna be really hard to just turn. So I'm gonna go that way. Then yeah, I'm gonna let you go. Probably won't sew it in that today. It is getting a bit late in the day. So let's see. Yeah, that's fine. That. That's that. I'm only going to put 5 sheets of paper in, so that'll make 20 sides. So it's only a small notebook, just add into a pocket. And say it's easy to whiz it down the machine, just about 5 sheets, including the cover, or even just quick doing 3 old pamphlet stitches, pretty quick. Depends what mood I'm in. Sometimes I think, oh, you know, I really can't be bothered to get the sewing machine out. And I say get it out, it's like on my desk. I've just got to like pull it forward. And then other times I think, oh, I can't be bothered to sew, you know, hand sew it in. So it really just depends what I feel like. But, you know, both work as well as each other type thing. So yeah, I don't think it matters. Right, so that's that one. Yeah, that's ended up. It's weird how that happened, that that other one looked better with the purple and then this one is better for that one. So yeah, that was a bit bizarre. So here they are, and I'm really pleased with them. I'm gonna say it started off so slow, I didn't think it was gonna come together, but it did. So yeah, but I'm gonna put this somewhere. I'm gonna put it in my Edith Auden box actually, to remind me to use that bit. But yeah, I was surprised that that didn't go with it. Maybe it's because I've chosen green and stuff, and it is very, very pastely. So maybe that was the reason. Right, that is me for today. So I hope you've enjoyed it. And I hope you've enjoyed seeing the snow. Shall we just have one? I'm going to pause and then I'm going to show you out the window. I don't know why it's looking blue, the colour. But yeah, you can't see the prettiness. But it is really very pretty. So if you see like beyond those houses, that's like where the fields are. So that's it. Bye from me.